With Simon in this mood, Lorraine decides to take some protection. Her 86-year-old mother-in-law, Edna.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Are you a duo?
They've let me come in. Hello, love. Hello, love. They've let me come in with my daughter-in-law.
Oh, this is your daughter-in-law?
Yeah. Oh, you don't sing together?
Oh, you sing.
No.
No, and who? Oh. Who is Lorraine?
This is Lorraine.
Oh, Lorraine. Oh, Lorraine. Why are you with her?
I'm just her mother-in-law.
Okay. Oh. For support.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks very much.
Is she any good?
Well, I think so.
Really?
Okay, oh, yeah? Just stand
watching
over there.
Thank
you. Okay. So, Lorraine, have you got the X Factor?
I have.
And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Begin the Begin.
Off you go.
Thank you. I'm with you once more under the stars and down by the shore an orchestra's playing and even the palms seem to be swaying when they begin the begin.
Thank you very much, Lorraine.
Lovely song.
What did you think
of it? It was
Lorraine?
A bit lifeless. What did you think?
I liked it all.
Would you buy her record?
Yes.
A bit biased. Okay, look, I've concentrated on the singing, Lorraine. I mean, there are other issues. I mean, you know, lack of personality, performance, all those things. It was terrible.
Okay, we're going to sum this up. I'm saying no.
I'm going to have to say no, Lorraine.
Simon, yes or no?
Absolutely, I'm afraid going to have to say no, Lorraine.
The competition's over for Lorraine, but mother-in-law Edna isn't happy with Simon.
It upsets me because he laughed.
Right.
He laughed and he shouldn't have laughed.
Edna can't contain herself. He's shattered dreams across the globe, but this time, Mr. Nasty has gone too far. One of the most powerful men in music is about to meet his match. Edna.
Simon?
What have I done?
What have you done? Go on.
What did I do?
You laughed.
I always laugh.
You, no, you don't. Do. No, you do not.
No, I apologise.
No, Simon. You want to alter your ways. Listen, Simon.
But this is really embarrassing.
Listen.
Okay.
You think you're better than anybody. I think you was very ignorant. Yes, you was ignorant, Simon.
Sorry.
Someone else expecting a yes is 17-year-old Kylie, who's already getting into the showbiz spirit by bringing her own entourage and her number one fan, her mum.
Look at me. You can take
hey.
It all because
this... My name's Kylie Knowles, but you can call me Kate Star. The K is for the Kylie and the star because I'm the star. This isn't no dream made, it's a reality. I will be having a number one single, a massive album, top of the chart.
So, after some final words from Mum...
You stop.
Oh, no,
I know. She's all going to be a star.
It's showtime for Kylie.
Why are you here today?
Basically, I live to perform and this is my opportunity and I just want to make the most of it.
Off you go.
Let the children's laughter.
She's
going to
do it more.
She can do it more. How we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs.
Okay, Kylie, thank you very much. Simon?
The truth?
Yes. Stop that. Hey, stop that.
You will never, ever make a career in music. It's hard when you're good. It's impossible when you're okay.
It's just not for you, Kylie.
I believe that I have got it, and there's people out there that believe I have got it, and I'm just going to work on them reasons. I want to make the most of my dreams, and I'm not just going to let them go by this.
Forget it.
Okay.
Kylie, he's just being honest with you. I don't think you're ever going to be a pop star. I'm going to have to say no.
No, Kylie. She's everything you ever wanted.
One moment. So it's not good news for Kylie, but her mum won't give up without a fight.
Kylie, I'm not going to patronise you and give you something like this because it's stupid. You don't have what it takes.
There's no letter proof. There's no, she hasn't got it.
Look how many.
I know that.
I can believe.
You've only heard it for
I've got to say, Mum, you are giving your daughter false hope here. You are.
You give so many.
No. You are giving her false hope.
I'm willing to give her.
No, because you have led her down the wrong path here. She's not going to be a pop star.
She won't. Will.
Soon enough, I'll be
making
something for myself.
Trust me, I'll make something for myself. Simon, you watch it. I bet you I'll be somebody bigger than you are. I will be somebody someday. You watch.
You take a break.
I think you don't have no clue what
her
he's on about.
Mum, Dad and sister.
I've been told by my mum and dad that I'm a good singer. That's why I've auditioned for The X Factor.
We just literally pushed her and pushed her and pushed her and got her to sing.
And to ensure that Emma not only sings like a star, but looks like one, her dad, Philip, has made her a show-stopping outfit.
I made this dress for my daughter. It took 3 days.
She's definitely got the gift. I think she follows in my footsteps, because I used to be in the choir.
What's your name?
Emma.
Emma, and why are you here today?
I've been told that I'm a good singer, so I've wanted to have a go.
Who picked your dress for you?
My dad's made it for me.
And is there anybody in the charts that you aspire to be like?
Celine Dion.
Okay.
Near, far.
I think she'll be a yes.
Heart does go on.
Let's hope and pray.
Love can touch us one time and let's forego. I can't do anymore.
Good.
I can't do anymore. So nervous.
It's fine.
So, Simon, what do you think?
Well, Emma, can I be honest with you? First of all, the dress is completely wrong.
Why?
Well, I'm not a fashion expert, Emma, but, you know, it's like a wedding dress, isn't it? And then you sang the song out of tune and a bit like a baby. A little bit.
I know you're only young. I don't want to be hard on you, but it just wasn't good. Emma, no. Not right.
No, Emma.
Danny?
No.
Four no's, but nice to meet you.
Thanks. See you.
None of them liked my dress.
None of them?
Not none of them.
What about your singing? What
are
they saying?
I can't sing.
What?
I can't sing.
Well, you can't sing, you can't.
Are you Emma's mum and dad?
We are, yeah.
Yeah, she's very upset. She's put her heart in this. Now, I used to sing in the choir myself, so I think...
If you're coming in here to give me a hard time, you've got to look at yourselves.
We've not pushed her.
God, you are the reason why this girl is going to be disappointed. I have to blame you guys for encouraging her to believe that she's going to do well in something which she's not.
What?
You've given her false hope. She can't sing.
She's won trophies. I've got trophies home, they're galore.
Yeah, but people who've won a rosette in a donkey derby don't go on to win the Grand National. Your daughter can't sing.
I
just downright ignorance. Yeah, I'm sorry, but I'm very upset myself.
Yeah. My right. God.
She's still not going to give up singing.
She can still try next year.
She can still try again next year, and we'll keep on trying.
So, it's back to Ramsbottom for Emma and her family.
She's got the X factor, I have got the wow factor.
She has got 100% star quality, she will go places.
I will shout Simon, who's the biggest and who's the best? And that I will win this, no matter what.
Go on, good luck.
Okay, Kelly. Go for it. Do your best, please.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
How are you?
Hi, I'm fine.
Good, this is Danny, this is Louis.
Hiya, hi, Louis.
How you doing?
Okay, what's your name, darling?
Kelly Norfolk.
And why are you here?
So I've got the X factor.
Which is?
Me.
Okay.
I may not have the looks, but I've got the X factor.
And who would you compare yourself to in the charts today?
Celine Dion, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey.
And how would you mark yourself out of 10 in terms of vocals?
10 out of 10.
Good. What are you going to sing?
I Will Always Love You.
Off you go, Kelly.
She'll make you cry. Sing it.
Every step of the way, and I will always love you, will always love you.
Thank you. Well, you sounded like a dog barking
sorry,
at the end.
I am so sorry.
Kelly, it was, I mean, you sang it in about 7,000 different keys. I think this is a pointless exercise. You haven't got a 10 out of 10 voice. At best, I would give you 2.5.
Thank you very much.
And that's being Kelly. Generous. Danny?
I can see you're really nervous, but I don't think you have the voice to win the X Factor.
Kelly, you're a nice girl, but your voice is just not as good as you think it is.
So it's a what?
It's a no for you.
No, Kelly. Not for me.
Okay, nice to meet you, Kelly.
Thank you very much.
Bye, sweetheart.
Thanks a lot.
What did she just say?
Very degrading. Could not be nicer. I think I'm being penalised because he just wants to get home. He's not giving anybody a chance. He seems to me very. He wants to get home. He wants to go to the pub, basically.
10 out of 10 Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, Celine Dion. And that sounded like Lassie.
Hi, Simon.
How do you do?
I'm her dad, her father.
What's your name?
Peter.
Peter. She was absolutely terrible in here, Peter. Can I say something? You are partly to blame for your daughter's delusion.
Why?
Because you've obviously encouraged her. It's crazy.
It's crazy. I think this is crazy.
No, but the whole thing is
Simon,
crazy.
Simon, all I'm asking you, please, can you give her one more? One
it's
more,
pointless.
Just one more.
It's pointless,
why
Peter?
Is it pointless? Because I know she can do it.
Peter, you don't. That's the whole point. You
I
don't
do.
Know.
I do.
This is my business. Your daughter isn't good enough.
Have you got, Simon, have you got a heart?
Yes.
Well, will you put your hand in your
but
heart?
I've also got a brain.
Where's your brain? In your middle toe.
Goodbye, Kelly.
You've been very, very harsh.
Nice to meet you, Kelly.
Very harsh.
Kelly, reality check, it's a
no. All you want to do is just go home, don't you? Excuse me.
Basically, you penalise our family.
Kelly,
you just piss off what you do.
Thank you.
Don't push me, I'm walking.
Okay, come get
I will shout you, Simon. Thank you. Simon, you are very, very rude. Oh,
there's an eye opener.
Being very rude.
Very rude. Thank you. Goodbye.
I could have earned Simon millions. Just think about it, Simon. When I'm big and famous, you could have been earning the money with me.